Let's come to the today's topic is what is next in manufacturing. So this is a Volvo example, and I'm sure there are some of the folks from Volvo as well. And this is a typical challenge which most of the industry is having, that the product development time has to be reduced by 50%. In 2012, Volvo has decided to reduce the product development time by 2020, which was earlier 42 months to 20 months. They have already reached somewhere around 25 months, but there are further reductions which they are working upon. So just understand on this slide, this doesn't lead the pressure only on OEM, but this leads the pressure on the suppliers who are supplying parts to the OEM. And what McKinsey folks are saying, if a product is late to market by 6 months, already 66% of its gross profit margins are lost. I'm sure we all are agreed upon that. So how additive manufacturing is helping industry to cope up with this? So there are three-dimensional strategy which most of the companies are having with additive manufacturing. One is offering and redesign, product design to improve product performance. So this is a great example where ULA, which is a joint venture between NASA and Boeing, they are using additive manufacturing part instead of a metal part. If you see here, the silver one, which is a traditional part which they used to use in spacecraft, which was having somewhere around 140 parts. And now if you see the right one, which is somewhere around golden in color, that is additive manufactured part. This has been manufactured using a material called Ultem, which is FST certified material, flame, smoke, toxicity. And now the part consolidation happened. If you see from 140 part, it has gone to 16 parts. Not only this, this also helped them to save costings in terms of raw material as well as weight reduction.